Hello, I'm Bernie Hayes. Today's guest is Scotty. You'll recognize him today on The Bernie Hayes Show. I said my guest is Scotty. Actually, he's Dr. Robert Lawrence Salter, but also now a gospel recording artist. Scotty, how you doing?
Yeah, Bernie, how are you?
So good to see you, man.
Always good to see you.
You know, but you keep changing hats on me. Now it's Scotty the recording artist. You know, I know you're Scotty the disc jockey. I know you're Scotty, Dr. Robert Lawrence Salter, the hospital administrator. You're now a gospel singer.
Who would imagine?
Yes, and the other album, the first album that you did, is doing so well. How is that album doing? What's the name of it?
The Journey.
The Journey.
It's still doing well. We had 11 songs that we recorded.
Yeah.
Two of them, Overcomer, and another one, We Just Can't Imagine It, hit number 4 on the Cashbox chart, and the other ones have done well, too. And so the journey's not over.
Yes.
We're going to continue to...
Barely just beginning, isn't it?
Yeah, just going to promote those songs into the next year. Mm-hmm. And there's still 2 or 3 songs that we're going to release as singles.
You also have an event coming up that you're over the American Cancer Society.
Right.
Tell us about that.
Well, December the 9th, mm-hmm. We're going to be doing a concert at the St. Louis Central Seventh-day Adventist Church,
okay.
Where we will introduce our new album, the Christmas album, called This Christmas. And we're going to be singing all the songs on the album. And the reason we're doing that is to raise money for the American Cancer Society.
Okay. So how'd you collaborate with that?
Well, I'm a cancer survivor.
Okay.
I guess it was about 5 years ago. I was diagnosed with prostate cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And fortunately, they caught it early enough. And I went through all the radiation treatment and all that. And so for the past 5 years, I've been cancer free.
So you're a survivor.
I'm a survivor.
Okay.
But I didn't take it lightly. Because there's so many people who aren't fortunate enough to catch it early, or for whatever reason don't have the financial resources to get treated, and it can be bad. So I thank the Lord for that, and I said to the Lord, if you get me through this, I will do something to show you honor and praise. And He said, well, you have a voice, don't you? So that was the idea for the album, and so the music is the vehicle that hopefully will get people to come to the concert and make donations to the Cancer Society.
I want to see that flyer again. Okay, this is the Christmas with Scotty and Friends in concert. Mary Louise, Victoria Elizabeth, Proclaim, Contemporary Christmas Favorites, free admission, donation benefiting the American Cancer Society. Tell us once again where it is, Scotty, and exactly what the location is.
It's 5 North Skinker Avenue. St. Louis, 63105. It's right next to Washington University off Skinker.
Okay. Off Skinker.
Mm-hmm.
5 North Skinker.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's good. And why do you want to bring them out at the same time, Scotty? Why do you want to release the album at the same time as the event?
Well, you know, I guess maybe a little ego. I think every singer would love to have a Christmas album because, you know, sometimes you want to have your legacy live on past you,
yeah.
And Christmas albums just go on and on and on every year. Christmas is the only holiday that has its own music,
yeah.
All right? So I'm hoping that this album will be around a long time, and so this is the time that you roll out a Christmas album. But also I wanted to do something this year to just thank the Lord for how He blessed me with this cancer.
Well, this song we're going to hear is a very song we're all familiar with from Donny Hathaway. Made it very, very famous.
St. Louis guy, by the way.
Yeah, but you did it in a very different way, in a very different tone, in a different ambiance is different. Let's listen to This Christmas by Scotty.
Is blazing bright. We'll be careful. Christmas for me. Yeah. Presents and cards are here. My world is filled with cheer. Outshine the town, yes they do. This Christmas, by your side is blazing bright. We'll be caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas.
Well, Scotty, that's unbelievable. Man, who did the arranging?
There's a guy at Clayton Studio named Tazu Marshall, and he helped me a lot with that. And also, the track was pretty amazing, too.
Right. Why did you select that particular song?
Well, because everybody likes it. To me, it's not Christmas unless I hear that song.
Right. Okay. Okay. Did you put any particular flavor into it that you thought would enhance your particular version of it?
Just a little bit, just a little bit. But you know, when you do covers of classics, it's challenging because people always hear the original version.
They compare them,
and they compare.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm just hoping that my version is comfortable with those who love the Donny Hathaway version, which will be going on forever.
I'm sure it's going to become a classic itself because it's very, very well done.
And
you're very articulate in doing so. And Scotty, how did you this conversion from disc jockey to pastor, more or less? You're an elder.
The journey, right?
Maybe I should have waited a little while, but we only have a minute left in the segment. I want to come back and explore that a little bit further.
Okay.
Yeah, we're talking to Dr. Robert Lawrence Salter. He has about 27 different advanced degrees, but right now we're talking about Scotty the singer, Scotty the composer, Scotty the entertainer. And we'll be right back. The New Life Evangelistic Center, this after this.
It was Platt and Petition that closed 1411 Locust Street. It's Platt and Petition that's keeping shelters from opening. Not a new shelter is open for 15 years. I thank God for courageous Aller men and Aller women that are standing up and taking a stand against this Platt and Petition. and are working for a homeless Bill of Rights. Yet there are those that are consumed by their own fears that aren't willing to do away with it, even though it means more and more people are having to sleep out on the streets. We could reopen 1411 Locust if it wasn't for the plat and petition. That's why we need you to be praying at this particular time, that caring people will rise up at this moment, contact their aldermen, alderwomen, to do away with this plat and petition in the city of St. Louis, and to see that a homeless Bill of Rights comes forth. So many people sing during the holiday seasons, away in the manger, there's no room in the inn, and all these different holiday songs, but somehow they just can't associate what they're singing about and the reality and the Christ child who's come with the homeless children that are on the streets right now. Those that are hurting, those that are victims of the redlining by bigotry lurking and fear lurking in the people's hearts that start a petition to shut down shelters like 1411 Locust and keep other shelters from opening like Peter and Paul wanted to open one in Carondelet. We got to pray they do away with this plat and petition, which is so discriminatory, and pray that the eyes, hearts, and minds of aldermen who are taking a stand against plat and petition will be silenced and will be able to see the hurting and the homeless helped. That's why a homeless Bill of Rights is so essential at this particular time. And as far as an action plan to get back into 1411 Locust, we have one of those waiting for you here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Just call us at 314-421-3020. That's 314-421-3020. And we'll send you one of those action plans. I'm Larry Rice, asking you to please care. Let the love and light of Christ flow through you and experience His love as you reach out and really help those who are hurting and in need.
Welcome back. My guest is Dr. Robert Lawrence Salter, also known as Scotty. Scotty the performer, Scotty the singer, Scotty the Christmas entrepreneur at this particular point. Scotty, how did you select the songs on this album?
Well, they're my favorite Christmas songs, basically. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Some of them go back a long time. Well, of course, the Christmas song that Nat King Cole made popular 75 years ago still sounds amazingly good. And that's another song that you don't know it's Christmas until you hear that song.
Right. Yeah.
So that was one. And then, of course, the Donny Hathaway song that we've already talked about. But mm-hmm. then there were a lot of good songs that came out in the 90s. That have become new Christmas classics, like Who Would Imagine a King? That was done by Whitney Houston.
Right.
And then there's another one called Don't Save It All for Christmas, Celine Dion.
Right.
She did an amazing version of that. And of course, Oh Holy Night is on there. And of course, that's an older song, but when Mariah Carey did it in the 90s, it became another Christmas song.
Became another new song, didn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Who Would Imagine a King?
Who Would Imagine a King?
Let's listen to that.
When the wise men arrived and the angels angels were singing your name, that the world would be different, 'cause you were alive. That is why heaven stood still to proclaim, one day an angel said quietly that soon he would bring something special to me. And of all those wonderful gifts he would bring, who would imagine? Who would imagine? Who would imagine a king?
Wow, Scotty, who would imagine a king? That's beautiful. That's really wonderful. Tell us once again why you selected that particular song.
Well, all of the songs kind of have a nice flavor to them. And the way I'm going to do the concert, I'm going to be able to connect each song to the next song as I go through it. But again, I take no credit for this. I think the Lord picked those songs because the way they flow together so nicely, you can just listen to the album over and over again, and it just puts you in a nice, peaceful place. And, you know, and I think that's what the reason for the season is.
Okay. Tell us about your church, and tell us about you. Scotty is a Christian.
Well, I was born into church. But when high school came along, most of my friends didn't go to church, and so I stopped going to church. And, of course, then later after college, had a group of friends. None of them went to church. And, you know, I went on as an adult into life has its way of getting your attention, and some ups and down things happened in my life. And I just decided, well, there has to be something better to this, you know. And so I gave my life to the Lord, and he said, okay, well, I got some work for you. And so I joined the Seventh-day Adventist Church, and that's a Christian church that worships on Saturday. And it's been a real blessing to me, and I've continued to grow spiritually. I'm currently teaching on BibleDiscoveryCenter.com, which is an online community Bible school. And I do that on Saturday afternoons, and right now we have a Daniel series that's going on right now.
Dr. Robert Lawrence Salter. Salter is a name that's very familiar with the St. Louis Public Schools. Tell us about who that is.
Well, that goes back to my dad and mom. My dad was a football coach at Vashon High School back in the day, and my mom taught at Turner Middle, and both of those were prominent schools at the time, and they had quite a reputation as educating people and becoming role models in the community. And so I try to follow that reputation myself, but it was difficult because Dad was a big time football coach, and sports is not my thing.
Right.
So I had to find something that I could do.
You were Bobby Salter.
Yes, not Big Ed.
Yeah.
And so I had to find something that I could do, and I ran into a guy named Bernie Hayes who said, "You got a pretty good voice."
Oh man, thank you for that.
That changed my life.
Tell us about your sister too.
My sister Lillian Salter Curtis, she followed mom's footsteps and became an educator. And she has taught in the Webster School District and also in Webster College. And now she's retired and just recently got awarded the Woman of the Year for the church over there that she attends.
Congratulations to her.
It was amazing.
Yeah. How have you been embraced, Scotty, as a singer?
It's hard to describe because most people who know me don't know me as a singer.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's, you know, who, what?
Yeah.
You know? But for those who don't know me and I present myself as a singer, they say, oh, okay, hey, you're not bad.
How can we get The Journey and how can we get this brand new CD?
Both of them are available on the same website. It's called scottythesinger.hearnow.com. Scotty the Singer, S-C-O-T-T-Y, T-H-E-S-I-N-G-E-R, scottythesinger.hearnow.com. And you can go to that website, and both of the albums are available, and where you can purchase them, which is all the major places where you can download digital music.
Scotty, this Christmas, Scotty the Singer. And is there a phone number they can reach you, Mr. Dr. Salter?
314-220-1587.
Say that again.
314-220-1587.
Okay. Now, you're also, Scotty Lawrence Robert Salter is in the National Black Radio Hall of Fame. In fact, you're a board member of the National Black Radio Hall of Fame, and you were inducted nationally last year. Has that helped in your singing career?
Actually, they don't really connect because, you know, gospel and R&B sometimes, you know, are not exactly the same audience sometimes. But I found that just knowing about radio has helped me promote the music.
Right.
And understanding how that happens. And trying to get a song played on the radio is challenging now because all the big companies, I mean, if you don't have a big company behind you, if you come as a solo artist, they say, who sent you? go get a representative. You know?
Yeah, but you've been promoting it very well. And well, like you said, to be on the Billboard, Cashboard charts, I mean, all these wonderful charts. And it's just amazing how you did that on your own.
Well, you know, thank you.
You're more than welcome.
It's been a journey.
It has been a journey. Scotty, we're going to take another short break here. But there's so many other things I want to talk to you about, and there's so many things I can talk to you about. But right now, we're going to talk about this wonderful event coming up for Christmas, and also the album when we come back.
Okay.
And we're at the New Life Evangelistic Center, 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri, where Larry Rice is still helping those in need. And for those unsheltered, for those people on the street, he's doing a marvelous job, and we need your help and support. We'll be right back with Scotty Lawrence after this.
Behind me is the New Life Evangelistic Center administrative offices in Overland, Missouri. And this is where we shoot our shows for our worship shows and the Here's Help Network. And it's also where Zakeed Baruti and Bernie Hayes shoot their shows. You can find all of these shows at the New Life Evangelistic Center app, the NLEC TV app. You can also access them on your tablet or on your computer. And this is how you can stay up to date with all the things that New Life Evangelistic Center is doing. There are so many different programs that we've got going on, and God is doing many exciting things through partners like you. So if you want to support the work that New Life is doing, then please access and give through the app. You can go online at nlecstl.org or give us a call at 314-421-3020. Again, 314-421-3020. But this is the best way to get plugged into the amazing work that New Life is doing through people like you. And so there is something for you to get involved in today. And we are so thankful for our partners. Only through the grace of God and your gift are we able to bless others today.
Today's subject, Nat King Cole, became the first African-American performer to host a variety TV series in 1956. He's best known for his soft baritone voice and singles like The Christmas Song, Mona Lisa, and Nature Boy. Born March 17, 1919 in Montgomery, Alabama, Nat King Cole was an American musical icon who first came to prominence as a jazz pianist. He owes most of his popular musical fame to a soft baritone voice, which became the first African-American performer to host a variety of television show and series for white families. He was the first black man welcomed to their living rooms each night. He maintained worldwide popularity until his death in 1965. Nat King Cole, trailblazer, icon, musician, Nat King Cole.
I have with the lady that's in our residential training program at our safe house. Tell everyone your name.
My name is Cherie. New Life actually just, for me, saved my life, and that's just me being completely honest. So for me, it's not just a name of being New Life, it is actually giving New Life, because I'm safe. I have a roof over my head. I have people that I'm talking to. I'm growing. I'm listening to the word more. And I'm connecting, and I love it. It's like a new energy has just come from inside of me that I didn't even know that I had.
Your prayers and gifts are absolutely critical at this time. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Or go online at nlecstl.org.
Scotty, once again, tell us about what's happening, what event is coming up, and why.
Well, a benefit concert scheduled December the 9th at the St. Louis Central Seventh-day Adventist Church. Mm-hmm. And it's a benefit concert on behalf of the American Cancer Society. And we're going to be debuting our new Christmas album this Christmas. And we're going to have Mary Louise and Victoria Elizabeth and Mike and the Chosen Ones. So everybody's going to be there. So it's going to be a great concert.
And it's a benefit to Cancer Society, American
Absolutely.
Cancer Society?
Yes.
And once again, tell us why.
Well, you know, cancer is something that affects all of us.
Mm-hmm. What is cancer?
Well, I'm glad you asked. Yeah. Cancer is an abnormal growth of cells that multiply out of control and spread to other parts of your body. Mm-hmm. And it's not a new thing. Cancer has been around, oh my gosh, since the beginning of time. Yeah. You know, archaeologists have discovered mummies, Egyptian mummies, and they now have the technology to do the DNA. And cancer was around back in Egypt in the Bible times, mm-hmm. and still around today. And so, but the good news is that cancer can be prevented. 50% of the people that have cancer could have avoided it had they done the proper pre-cancer screening and the right treatments.
Okay. As a former hospital administrator, as I know you were at one time, mm-hmm. as knowledgeable as you are, you've given your life to Christ. How is this helping you help the American Cancer Society?
Well, I think that I'm just thankful that I have an opportunity to do something. You know, when we think about something big like cancer, we assume that, well, there's nothing I can do. But there's an organization out there, a national organization called the American Cancer Society that has been around for a long time, and that is what they do. They promote cancer research. They give treatments to individuals who need counseling and that kind of thing. But also they're great at educating the community about the signs and symptoms of cancer so that persons can know how to get treated.
So this new CD that you have will also benefit the American Cancer Society.
Absolutely.
Well, Scotty, you know, it's such a wonderful thing having you here. And the last song that we're going to hear from the CD is one that everyone is very familiar with, mm-hmm. written by Mel Torme, made famous by Nat King Cole, Nathaniel Cole, mm-hmm. the Christmas song.
75 years ago.
Let's hear it. And Scotty, I just want to say thank you as we leave. Thank you so much and good luck.
Thank you.
And once again, I guess we can tell where you're listening to Nat Cole now. Oh, that's a beautiful song. And we're listening to it now. But I just want to say thank you, Scotty, and good luck.
Thank you.
What date is the concert again?
December the 9th.
December the 9th.
Saturday night, 7
Saturday
o'clock.
Night. And more phone number again?
314-220-1587.
Thank you, Scotty. Let's listen to Scotty sing the Christmas song.
And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.